Hey friends, welcome back. I hope that you had a great Easter, and now we're back. We're in a new unit, and this unit is all about the continuation of God's story. So last unit, we talked about Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and today we're gonna be starting on the story of Joseph. Now, I'm sure you are all familiar with the story of Joseph, and you know the story about the multicolored coat and all of his dreams, and we're gonna get into that in just a bit. But before we get started, I want us to go over the question that I want you to think about throughout this unit, and that is there anything God cannot do? Now, I am sure that you have your own thoughts and you have your answer already to go. But before we get any further, let's listen and learn a little bit more about Joseph.
Jacob and his family lived in Canaan, the land God had promised to his grandfather Abraham and his family. Jacob had 12 sons, but his favorite son was Joseph. Jacob gave Joseph a colorful robe. Joseph's brother saw that Jacob loved Joseph most, and they hated Joseph. One day, Joseph told his brothers about a dream he had. He dreamed that he and his brothers were putting together bundles of grain. Suddenly, Joseph's grain stood up and other bundles bowed down to his. The dream meant that Joseph would rule over his brothers. Joseph's brothers hated Joseph even more. Then Joseph had another dream. In this dream, Joseph saw the sun, the moon, and 11 stars bowing to him. This dream meant all of Joseph's family, his brothers, his mother, and his father would one day bow down to Joseph. Joseph's brothers were more jealous. Sometime later, Jacob sent Joseph to check on his brothers, who were tending to the sheep. When the brothers saw Joseph coming, they decided to kill him. But Joseph's oldest brother, Reuben, did not want to kill Joseph. "Let's just throw him into a pit," he said. When Joseph arrived, the brothers took off Joseph's colorful robe and threw him into the pit. Then they saw a caravan of people heading to Egypt. They decided to sell Joseph to the travelers as a servant for 20 pieces of silver. The travelers took Joseph to Egypt. The brothers dipped Joseph's colorful robe into blood and took it back to their father. "We found this robe," they said. Jacob recognized the robe. He believed a wild animal had killed Joseph, and he cried loudly because he thought his favorite son was dead. Joseph's brothers turned against him and tried to kill him. But God protected Joseph and used him as a part of his plan to rescue his family. In a similar way, people turned against God's son, Jesus. Jesus' death was God's plan to rescue sinners.
I know. My daughter asked me this question the other day. "Mommy, why does God have so many strange stories in the Bible?" And this is no different. It seems really hard to hear. I mean, Reuben, he might not have wanted to kill his brother Joseph, but he suggested putting him in a pit. And then his brother Judah was the one that came up with the brilliant idea of selling him and sending Joseph off to Egypt. But in every situation, God had a plan and he has a purpose. And he used Joseph in a very strategic and specific way to create a remnant of people. A remnant is something small and it is taken from something larger. And that is what God is doing. All throughout this story, he has chosen and picked people. And he does it for his glory and our good. And we're going to learn a little bit of how God brought good around in this situation next week. But right now, we here are at the point in the story where Joseph's brothers sold him into slavery. Tough stuff. But thankfully, the story doesn't end there. We learn that God, he's going to use this story, and he's going to use Joseph in a way to save his people. And that is amazing. God always is going to take bad situations that we find ourselves in. And we're in those situations because the world has sinned. We are fallen and we have come short of God's glory. But because he loves us so much, he finds ways of bringing his glory about so he gets all the honor and all the praise and he is made famous. So next time you think that the stories in the Bible are super strange, just think every story is about God's glory. And how amazing is it that God can use really horrible situations and make them really amazing?
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Today, Carter from Fremont, California asks,
my dad lost his job, and now my family has to move. Why did God let this happen?
Carter, that is a great question. And you know, it really reminds me of Joseph's life that we're reading about in today's story. Because Joseph went from being a favored son in his father's home to being sold by his own brothers into slavery in Egypt. And I'm sure he had many times where he asked himself, why is this happening? What is going on? You know, we see in Joseph's life as well that in time, he came to understand that God was bringing everything to pass, even those hard things, for God's glory and his own good. And so we know that we are to trust in God. We may not understand what he's doing, and things in life can be difficult, but we trust God that he's got a plan. Romans 8:28 tells us that God works all things, and that includes hard things, together for his glory and our good. So our role is to trust God in the moment, knowing that he's a good God and he's got a good plan for our lives. So can you think of a time when in your life, when God brought something good out of something difficult?
I have been the Lord your God.
I have been the Lord.
So the question that we asked at the beginning of our lesson today was, is there anything God cannot do? And the answer is, God can do all things according to his character. So that means that God is merciful and he will do things according to his mercy. God is faithful and he will show his faithfulness throughout all generations. Our key passage comes from Hosea 13:14, and it says, "But I have been the Lord your God ever since you came out of Egypt. You shall acknowledge no God but me, no Savior except me." We know that Jesus is our Savior. God is our Creator and our King. And because of that, he will work all things out for his glory and our good. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you that you know and you see. And Lord, when things get bad, we know that you will work them for your good. It might not be easy and it might not be fun, but we know that you are faithful and that you care for us and that you have a plan and you have a purpose. So Lord, I pray that you would help us trust you in all things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. See you guys next week.